Welcome to everyone for GATE preparation. So first of all, I myself, Yadavan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Panimalar Engineering College. So today we are going to see integral calculus. Integral calculus. So from integral calculus, we are going to see definite integral, improper integral, and partial differential equation. Right. So, integral calculus. Right. So, in this section, we try to find out area of an irregular region. Irregular regions, because for regular regions we can find area. For example, take a rectangle L into B, triangle half time of base into height, circle we know very well pi r square, but we cannot find out area of a irregular region. Irregular regions or a region with the curved sides. Curved sides. You can see one example for curved sides. So this we have no formula to find a area. So we need some techniques. That is integration. That is integration. So how to find out the area of a irregular region or a region with the curved surface? That is very, very important. That is we are going to learn here. And some formulas and different types of functions, how to integrate. Right. See this curve. We need to find this area between a to b, right? So divide n number of sub intervals a to b. Each sub intervals we call del x. Look at that, del x. So this breadth del x, and this is height. So find out each rectangle area and add all rectangle. We found this entire region area, right? So finding each rectangle area one by one, it is very difficult. So we need a formula, that is summation I equal to 1 to n f of xi del x. So summation means what? We are adding these rectangles. So summation n number of sub intervals. Suppose you have 10, put I equal to 1 to 10. If you want more accurate area, take more number of rectangles. Right. Summation I equal to 1 to n f of xi del x. F of xi is given curve. Del x is breadth for rectangles. But using this formula, finding area is difficult. So we need another formula. That is, we are generally using integral a to b f of x dx equal to f of b minus f of a. This is generally we are doing. That is integration f of x, then substituting upper limit minus lower limit. Clear? Right. This is the technique to find the area using integration. Now, This list is important for integration. Integral x power n dx equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Then 1 by x dx log x. We know all this, but we should know for integral this formulas. Sin x minus cos x, cos x sin x, like this. Not only this, we have many formulas. I listed a very important only, but we need more formulas. You can see in textbook. Right. Now, properties of definite integrals. So first of all, what is definite integral? Very simple. The integration with the limit. See, a to b, the integration with the limit, that is called a definite integral. So we have properties. If you know this properties, you can integrate easily. If any type of any difficult or easy or given function, you can integrate easily. Right. First formula, a to b f of x dx equal to minus, sorry, a b to a f of x dx. Read like b to a, lower limit to upper limit. Read from lower limit to upper limit. So lower limit to b, upper limit a, b to a f of x dx, you can write minus of a to b f of x dx. What is the difference? Just we are changing the limits, reverse upper limit to lower limit, order changing only. Okay, when you're changing this limit, put the minus. That is the difference. Then a to b f of x dx, you can write a to c f of x dx plus c to b f of x dx. The condition, the c must be lies between a to b, between a to b. You have this condition, you can write like. Third, integral a to b f of x dx, you can write integral a to b f of a plus b minus x dx. That is, we are adding this limits. Right? Then 0 to a f of x dx equal to integral 0 to a f of a minus x dx. Upper limit a, we are subtracting the x. Right? This is very, very important formula. You have seen many situation. Minus a to f of x dx equal to 2 times of 0 to f of x dx if f of x is an even, 0 if f of x is an odd function. So how to find given function is f of x, given function is, sorry, f of x is even, even f of x is odd. Very simple. Putting minus for x, it gives f of x, positive x, then f of x is even. If you are putting minus for a given function, it gives minus f of x, then f of x is odd, then integral value 0. You can put directly, okay. Right, next, 0 to 2 f of x dx equal to 2 times of 0 to a f of x dx. If f of 2a minus x equal to f of x. See, this condition is very, very important. You first check this, then only you can do like 0. The function is odd. So even odd, you need to check. Right. Now we say problems based on definite integral, based on this properties, using this properties. Without knowing this properties, this is difficult to evaluate. So that's why these properties are very important. Okay. Evaluate. First problem, evaluate. Limit integration 2 to 3. Root of x divided by root of 5 minus x plus root x dx. Listen, this is definite integral. How we identify this integration with the limit. This integration with the limit. Okay. Let I given integration. Now I used property number 3. Property number 3. That is, see, I have written property number 3. A to b f of x dx equal to integral a to b f of a plus b minus x into dx. So this I used here. Look at that. I used here. See, a and b, a equal to 2, b equal to 3, a plus b minus x equal to 5 minus x. Substitute. Instead of x, write 5 minus x. Instead of this x, 5 minus x. And for this x, write 5 minus x. Right. Okay. Then 2 to 3, root of 5 minus x. See, plus 5, minus 5 cancel. Minus minus plus, minus minus plus, minus minus plus, so root x only, and this 5 minus root of 5 minus x. Now very simple, add 1 and 2, add 1 and 2, you see the magic, add 1 and 2, see, I plus I, I plus I, I plus I 2i equal to integral 2 to 3, first one, equation number 1. We have written here, and equation number 2, add this two, right? See, both the integral limit is same. Both the integral limit is same. You can take only one integral, so 2 to 3. Then you can add this functions. See, both the denominators are same. You can add numerator, root x plus root of 5 minus x divided by root x plus root of 5 minus x. See, same. Denominator both same. Numerator you can add. Look at that. Root x plus root of 5 minus x. Yes. So numerator denominator same. You can cancel. You can cancel. So 1 only. That is 1 only. 1 only. Now integrate. Integration dx what? X. The limits are 2 to 3. Upper limit 3. Lower limit 2. So 1. Already we have 2i. So 2i equal to 1. I equal to 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Right. Next problem, evaluate integral 0 to pi by 2 dx by square root of 1 plus tan x. So trigonometric function given. So algebraic function differentiation is difficult, more than difficult trigonometric function. Okay. So how to integrate? Yes. I equal to integral 0 to pi by 2 dx by root of 1 plus tan x dx. Take equation number 1. Also, I equal to integral 0 to pi by 2 dx by root of 1 plus tan pi by 2 minus x. Property number 4. That is, property number 4. Integral 0 to a f of x dx equal to integral 0 to a f of a minus x. Difficult. 0 to a f of a minus x dx. Right. So, f of x equal to f of a minus x. So tan x equal to tan of pi by 2 minus x. A is pi by 2. Right. Integral 0 to pi by 2 dx square root of 1 plus. See, tan of pi by 2 minus x is cot x. Tan of pi by 2 minus x is cot x. Right. This cot x, you can write 1 by tan x. So root 1 is root 1 will leave it. Then cross multiply. Then you get root of tan x by root of tan x plus 1. Take this root of tan x on numerator. Then you get this. Right. Okay. Take this as equation number 2. Now take equation number 1 and equation number 2. Add I plus I 2i here, integral 0 to pi by 2 dx by 1 plus root of tan x, that is given plus equation number 2. See, both the denominators are same, the integral limits are same, so you can write only one integral 0 to pi by 2, 1 plus root of tan x, So you can add numerator here 1, consolidated 1, 1 plus root of tan x, 1 plus root of tan x. So you can cancel this 2, you can cancel this 2. So integral 0 to pi by 2 dx only. So 0 to pi by 2 dx. Now integration of dx is x, limit 0 to pi by 2, so upper limit to first, next lower limit, so only pi by 2. So here 2i. So I equal to pi by 4. I equal to pi by 4. Next. Prove that 0 to pi by 4 log of 1 plus tan x dx equal to pi by 8 log 2. Take I, given function, by property 4. What is property 4? 0 to f of x dx equal to integral 0 to f of a minus x dx. Right? So this upper limit, you can subtract with the x. See? I equal to integral 0 to pi by 4 log of 1 plus tan pi by 4 minus x, that is f of x, you can write f of a minus x. So log of tan x, you can write log of 1 plus tan pi by 4 minus x, right? Tan pi by 4 minus x, see formula, tan pi by 4 minus x, you can write like tan pi by 4 minus tan x divided by 1 plus tan pi by 4 tan x, which is equal to, this is formula, this is trigonometric formula, tan of pi by 4 minus x, you can write tan pi by 4 minus tan x divided by 1 plus tan pi by 4 tan x. Okay, tan pi by 4 value 1, tan pi by 4 value 1. Right. Right. Now, come here. See, we need 1 plus tan pi by 4 minus x. Here we are going to form 1 plus tan pi by 4 minus x, simple form. See, 2 by 1 plus tan x. Okay, how we get, listen, 1 plus, see, we have tan pi by 4 minus x, 1 minus tan x be 1 plus tan x. So 1 plus, 1 minus tan x be 1 plus tan x, right? This cross multiply, 1 plus tan x plus 1 minus tan x. Tan x cancel, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 by 1 plus tan x. So 1 plus tan pi by 4 minus x, simplest form, 2 by 1 plus tan x. Now you substitute here. Instead of this, we substitute 2 by 1 plus tan x, log of 2 by 1 plus tan x, right? See, equation number 1 and equation number 2, add 1 and 2, then 2i, integral 0 to pi by 4, log of 1 plus tan x, plus integral 0 to pi by 4, log of 2 by 1 plus tan x dx, just we found, equation number 2, right? See, the limits are same, and write only one integral. Here log, add this two function, log a plus log b, what, log a b, 1 plus tan x, 2 by 1 plus tan x, 1 plus tan x, 1 plus tan x, cancel, log 2 only, log 2 what, constant, take out log 2, so integral 0 to pi by 4 dx, right? 2y equal to log 2, so integral dx what, x 0 to pi by 4, pi by 4 minus 0, pi by 4 minus 0, then 2i equal to pi by 4 log 2, I equal to pi by 8 log 2 in 2. Next one, different form, that is, given limit we are going to separate, right, separate and integrate, see, evaluate. Integral minus 1 to 3 f of x dx, if f of x equal to 1 minus x, x square minus 1. 1 minus x, then it's valid from minus 1 to 0. X square, when it is valid 0 to 2. Minus 1, when it is valid between 2 to 3. Right. So this minus 1 to 3 separated to 3 interval minus 1 to 0, 0 to 2, 2 to 3. So write 3 integration, write 3 integration, right? So first, minus 1 to 0, look at that, minus 1 to 0, f of x dx plus 0 to 2, f of x dx plus 2 to 3, f of x dx, right? Very simple now. So minus 1 to 0, what is f of x? 1 minus x. Look at that. 0 to 2, what is f of x? X square. Substitute here. 2 to 3, f of x, 2 to 3, f of x minus 1. Substitute here. Now integrate. First, integration 1 x, integration x, x square by 2. The limits are minus 1 to 0. X square integration, x cube. Limits are 0 to 2. Take out minus integral dx, x, substitute. Upper limit, lower limit. Now substitute the limits. First upper limit, next lower limit. Putting x equal to 0 and x equal x square equal to 0. What total you get? 0. See? 0. Then lower limit. So for lower limit, you have to substitute minus. You know that? Put x equal to minus 1. Put x equal to x square equal to minus 1. Okay, x equal to minus 1, minus 1, and this minus. So x square equal to minus 1, what? Plus. Okay, so plus 1. And then upper limit to 2, lower limit to 0. Upper limit to 8, lower limit 0. Leave it. So x equal to 3, x equal to 2. Then add this all, we get 19 by 6. Fifth, evaluate. Fifth problem, evaluate. Integral 0 to 3, modulus of x square minus 4 dx. So this is completely different. See, given function in a modulus. Okay. Given function in a modulus. What is modulus of x? Modulus of x value. Okay. Modulus of x plus x minus x. Plus x valid, x greater than or equal to 0. Minus x valid, x less than 0. So modulus of x means what? X and minus x plus x, x greater than 0, x less than 0. Okay, first we should know that. Otherwise we can't proceed this integral, right? So what is modulus x? We first know this, right? Okay. So, but here modulus of x square minus 4, right? Take one positive and a negative. Okay, positive when valid, we should find that. Okay, negative when value we should find. So x square minus 4 greater than or equal to 0. We need a x square minus 4 greater than or equal to 0. When it is possible. See, x greater than or equal to 2. Substitute x equal to 2 greater than or equal to 0. 3 greater than 0. 4 greater than 0. Okay. X greater than or equal to 2. So minus of x square minus 4. We need less than 0. When x square minus 4 less than 0. X value less than 2. So 1, 0. 1 and 1. Okay. So x less than 2. Okay. So this x greater than or equal to 2. X less than 2. You can write like 0 to 2, 2 to 3. See, x greater than or equal to 2. X less than. So starting limit is 0, ending limit is 3. So you can write between these two. So x less than 2, x greater than 2. Right, okay. So 0 to 2. So first write the function. So x square minus 4, positive. When it is possible? Between 2 to 3. Minus of x square minus 4. If x less than 2. See, x less than 2, x greater than 2. Right? We divided given limit into two parts. The 0 to 2, 4 minus x square dx plus 2 to 3, x square minus 4 dx. So, integration 4, 4x, x square integration, x cube by 3 plus integral 2 to 3 x square x cube by 3 4 4x so upper limit 8 plus upper limit 8 that is 27 put x equal to 3 27 by 3 minus 12 put x equal to 2 8 put x equal to 2 8 right then we get 22 23 by 3
yeah
so try more problems from improper sorry definite integral now next we see improper integral what is improper integral right. See definition in a definite integral in which one or both the limits of integration are infinite is called an improper integral of the first type they may in the form a to infinity f of x dx minus infinity to b f of x dx minus infinity to infinity f of x dx that is first of all definite integral means integration with the limit okay so in the definite integral the integration limits may be infinite that may be in the form a to infinity minus infinity to b both the limits are infinite sometimes minus infinity to infinity so this kind of integrals are called improper integral this kind of integrals are kind of improper integrals right see this is first kind we may take first type one okay we will see some problems in first type next I will explain type two second kind the improper integral is said to be converges means what finite limit so a to infinity f of x dx equal to limit b tends to infinity a to b f of x dx see one improper integral you can integrate like this form only if you have improper integral you must form a proper integral then integrate we cannot integrate with the improper integral that is not a correct so our job is we are changing this improper into proper how to make like limit b tends to infinity that infinity we are mentioning as b now it is proper form a to b f of x dx now integrate then substitute b tends to infinity right minus infinity to b f of x dx equal to minus infinity to b f of x dx equal to limit a tends to minus infinity a to b f of x dx right then both the limits are infinity then how to write a proper integral limit a tends to minus infinity to 0 f of x dx no need to write a to 0 f of x dx plus limit b tends to infinity upper limit infinity so 0 to b f of x dx r exist means finite then the proper improper integral is convergence otherwise we said divergent means what integral value we get infinity right the problems evaluate integral 0 to infinity dx by x square plus 1 solution the given integral is an improper integral first kind since the upper limit of integration is infinite right see how to find out the given integral is improper integral very simple the given integral limit what any one infinite or both the limit infinite here 0 to infinity so this is improper integral first type right okay how to integrate this type of integral the given this is given function right improper integral now write as a proper So limit b tends to infinity, take this infinity as a b, b tends to infinity, right? So 0 to b ex by x square plus 1. Now this is proper. Now integrate. 1 by x square plus 1 integration tan inverse of x. 0 to b. Limits are 0 to b. First upper limit, next lower limit. Then you get this. Tan inverse of 0 what? 1. Sorry, tan inverse of 0, 0. Tan inverse of 0, 0. Then tan inverse of b. See, b tends to infinity. We have b here. So what is the meaning? B tends to infinity. You have to apply. Tan inverse of infinity. Tan inverse of infinity what? Pi by 2. Pi by 2. Right. Evaluate. One simple problem. Evaluate integral 1 to infinity 1 by x square dx if it exists. If it exists means if it is a finite. It is a finite. Right. Integral value is finite. Right. Let I equal to given in given integral. Integral 1 to infinity 1 by x square dx. Write as a proper form. Write as a proper form. B tends to infinity. B tends to infinity. 1 to b 1 by x square dx. Integration of 1 by x square what? Minus 1 by x. Integration of 1 by x square minus 1 by x. Upper limit b, lower limit 1. So upper limit b, lower limit 1. B tends to infinity, minus 1 by infinity. Then this 0. Sorry, then this 1. 1 by infinity what? 0. 0 plus 1? 1. So convergent. Exist. Another one. Evaluate minus infinity to plus infinity. Evaluate minus infinity to plus infinity. X e power minus x square dx if it exists. See, this is third type. Both the limits are infinite. Both the limits are infinite. So minus infinity to plus infinity. I'm going to write minus infinity to 0, 0 to infinity. X e power minus x square f of x, x e power minus x square f of x. See, I take I1, I take I2. So, integrate separately, then add. So, first, minus infinity to 0, minus infinity to 0, x e power minus x square dx. So, lower limit one, the lower limit is infinity. So, a tends to minus infinity, a to 0, x e power minus x square dx. Put to t equal to x square. Put to t equal to x square. Put t equal to x square. Dt equal to 2x dx. X dt by 2. That is dt by 2. X dx. When x equal to a, that is we are using substitution integral. We are using substitution method. Okay. We are integrating using substitution. Okay. That is we are changing the variable x into t. We are changing the variable x into t. X into t. When changing the variable, we should change the limit. We should change the limit. A to 0, we should change. See here in terms of x, we should change in terms of t. So put x equal to a here, then t equal to a square. Put x equal to 0 here, t equal to 0. Then x equal to a, t equal to a square, t equal to 0, t equal to 0, right? Then what is x here? Not x. Now, x dx equal to 1 by 2 dt. So for x dx, substitute 1 by 2 dt, e power minus x square is e power minus t. Integration of e power minus t, minus e power minus t. Limits are a square 0, so put 0 and a square. E power 0, 1, so minus 1. E power minus a square, so minus minus plus. Then, b a tends to minus infinity, so minus infinity. Substitute here infinity, minus infinity, a square, so plus infinity. So, however, we get e power minus infinity. E power minus infinity what? 0. Then minus 1 by 2. Similarly, the second one, we get 1 by 2, add this to get 0. Finite limit exists. For practice, take this to problems. Take this to problem. Next, improper integral of the second kind. improper integral of the second kind. Very simple. First kind means the limits are infinite. But here, limits are finite. F of x is undefined, not defined, or discontinuous. F of x is not defined or a discontinuous. How we find f of x is not defined or discontinuous? Very simple. Substitute this limits into f of x. Substitute this limit into f of x. Suppose when substituting a, f of x is undefined. Undefined means what? Not defined means what? Infinite. You get f of x tends to infinite. When putting b tends to f of x, f of x tends to infinite. So we can say this type of function is not defined. So this type of function is improper integral of second kind. Then how to solve this type of integral? Right. See, f of x is not defined at a. F of x is not defined at a. That means when substitute x equal to a in f of x is to infinity. Then how to write a proper integral, then integrate. Right. Limit t tends to 0. Limit t tends to 0. T tends to 0. So a plus t. See, a tends a at a, f of x is not defined. So add with a. So a plus t to b f of x dx. Now it is a proper form. Right. Next, if f of x is not defined at b, that is f of x is not defined at b, right? So t tends to 0, b minus t, a to b minus t f of x dx. So subtract with t, b subtract with b, right? Why we are plusing in the lower limit, why subtracting in the upper limit? Very simple. See, this is increasing one. A to b means increasing, value increasing. That's why adding. B minus t means b to a. You can say b to a. A to b, next is b to a. So decreasing. That's why we are subtracting. Okay? Subtract. Right. Right. So for upper limit, subtract. Lower limit, add. Okay? Keep it in mind. Next, f of x is not defined at c. That means at a f of x defined, at b f of x defined, between a to b f of x is not defined. So that type of case is third one. So limit t tends to 0, a to c minus t, that is a to b we are separating into two integral, because f of x is not defined between a to b, so we are separating. So a to c minus t, that c is at c, f of x is not defined. So a to c minus t f of x dx plus t tends to 0, c plus t b f of x dx, right? The improper integral is said to be convergent if the limit of the above integral exists and diverges if fails to exist. Right, problems. Evaluate integral 2 to 5 dx by root of x minus 2. See, the given integral is an improper integral of second kind, is not defined at x equal to 2. Why? When substituting x equal to, see, lower limit 2, when substituting x equal to 2, when substituting x equal to 2, 2 minus 2 are 0, 1 by 0, infinity. F of x is not defined. So this is improper integral, second type, right? So lower limit, when substituting lower limit, f of x is not defined. So lower limit means you are adding t tends to 0, integral 2 plus t to 5 dx by root of x minus 2, right? Limit t tends to 0. See, now integration. See, 1 by root of x minus 2. We have 1 by root of x minus 2, f of x. But we have a formula we have formula. What is integral 1 by 2 root of x minus 2 dx is root of x minus 2 integral. If you have this form 1 by 2 root of x minus 2, you can write root of x minus 2, but we have only 1 by root of x minus 2. This 2 is missing. This 2 is missing. That's why we are taking 2 by 2. So this 2, this 2 here, and 1 by 2 root of x minus 2 integration, what? Root of x minus 2. See, this is formula. I have taken limit 2 plus t and 5. 2 plus t and 5. So upper limit, put x equal to 2. Sorry, x equal to 5. Put 3 only. Look at that, 3. Put a lower limit, x equal to 2 plus t. See here. Then plus 2 minus 2 cancel. Then t tends to 0. Only 2 root 3. That is required. That is required. We are missing one term. I need to correct it. Here, we are missing, I missed it, minus. The substitute and check it, okay? Right, next term. So next problem, one simple problem. For improper integral, test the convergence of means check whether it is a finite or infinite. Right. So minus 2 to plus 2 dx by x square. Okay. When putting minus 2, f of x is finite. When putting plus 2, f of x is finite. Then how it is improper integral? This is third type. That is, f of x is not defined between minus 2 to 2. When putting x equal to 0, one by zero, infinite. So f of x discontinuous or not defined. Okay, so listen carefully. What is f of x given and limits? Right. So minus 2 to 2 dx by x square given. So putting x equal to 0, f of x is discontinuous. So we are separating this limit into 2 to 0, 0 to 2, sorry, minus 2 to 0, 0 to 2. Look at that, minus 2 to 0, 2 to, sorry, 0 to 2. Okay, t tends to 0, so subtract, that is 0 minus t, and t tends to 0, add. 0 plus t. Now it is proper. Now you can integrate. Right. Integration of 1 by x square is minus 1 by x. Upper limit 0 minus t, lower limit minus 2. Again, integration of 1 by x square is minus 1 by x. Okay? Right. Substitute upper limit, next lower limit. See, put x equal to 0 minus t. Look at that. And put x equal to minus 2. Upper lower limit. Next, put x equal to 2. See this. Put x equal to 0 minus t. See this. Right. Now, put t tends to 0. So 1 by 0. So what 1 by 0? Infinite. So throughout this addition, what you get? Infinite. The given integrals divergence to infinity. Next, third one. Test the convergence of 0 to 3 dx by x minus 1 solution. Putting x equal to 0, f of x finite. Putting x equal to 3, 1 by 2, infinite. Then, where this f of x gets discontinuous? So between 0 to 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So 1 and 2, put into 1. Put 1, 1 minus 1, 0. So at x equal to 1, f of x is not defined. So this 0, 2, 3, you can separate 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 3, 1 to 3. So numerator, sorry, for upper limit, you have to separate, subtract t. For lower limit, you have to add t, right? Limit t tends to 0, limit t tends to 0. Integration 1 by x minus 1. Integration of 1 by x minus 1, what? Log of x minus 1. Similarly, log of x minus 1. Substitute upper limit and a lower limit. Upper limit and a lower limit. So upper limit 1 minus t. Upper limit 1 minus t. So put 1 minus t for x equal to 1 minus t and x equal to 0. So you get log of minus 1. Similarly, put x equal to 3, put x equal to 1 plus t. See, plus 1 minus 1 cancel, plus 1 minus 1 cancel, log of minus t, that is 0, log of 0 infinite. So overall this is infinite. This the given integral is divergent, not finite. Next topic, partial derivatives, derivation. First of all, rate of change. So ordinary differential equation, partial differential equation. What is ordinary differential equation? Y with respect to x. So only one independent variable, ordinary differential equation. dy by dx. Y dependent variable, x independent variable. So in ordinary differential equation, you have only one independent variable. So partial derivative means what? More than one independent variable. Look at that. Suppose we have f of x comma y is a function of two independent variables, x and y. So we treat y as a constant and find the derivative of f of x comma y with respect to x, then the derivative is called the partial derivative. That is, the given function in terms of x and y. So you cannot integrate, sorry, you cannot differentiate x and y at the same time. Okay, so first you have to differentiate with respect to x. There you put y as a constant. Next, differentiate with respect to y. There you put x as a constant. That is partial derivative. See, the problem you can understand easily. If z equal to x power 4, y power 4 minus 4ax square y square. Find dou z by dou x, dou z by dou y. Okay, first we see first order. One time of differentiation, we say first order. Continuously differentiate, second order, third order. Right. So first dou z by dou x. So z with respect to x. See here, x and y. But we are differentiating only x with respect to x. Z with respect to x. Z with respect to x means you are differentiating only x. So x power 4 differentiation, 4x cube. 4x cube. Here y constant. Differentiation of y what? Constant what? 0. So we don't write. Differentiate partially with respect to x. X differentiate only x. So x square differentiation, 2x. 2 into 4, 8. So ax y square. That is dou z by dou x, partial derivative. Next, dou z by dou y. What I said, with respect to y, with respect to y, the x is constant. X is constant. So this x power 4 differentiation with respect to y, 0. Y power 4 differentiation, 4y cube. Y square differentiation, 2y. 2 into 4, 8. A, x square, y. See, in a multiple, x is constant. Don't. Right. Next, dou square is z by dou x square. Dou square is z by dou x square. Dou square is z by dou x square. You can write dou by dou x into dou z by dou x. You can separate. You can separate. So first, see, we have dou z by dou x. Dou z by dou x. You differentiate one time. So dual x square minus 8 a y square. How we get? You are differentiating only. You are differentiating only. Differentiating only x. So 4x cube you can write 12x square. Differentiation of x 1 to 8a y square. Next, dou square is z by dou y square. You can write dou by dou y into dou z by dou y. So we have dou z by dou y. So differentiate one more time with respect to y. So 4y cube you can write 12y square. And 8ax square. Here differentiating only y. The minus 8ax square. Next, dou square z by dou x dou y. See, you can separate dou z dou by dou x into dou z by dou y. See, we have a dou z by dou y. Look at that. That one differentiate with respect to x. That is, yeah, differentiating only x. Okay, here y constant, here y constant, here no x term, so 0. This x square differentiation 2x, 2 into 8, 16, so 16 ax y, right. And simple problem, if u equal to log of root of x square plus y square, find dou by dou x, dou by dou y, given u equal to half log of x square plus y square, only find dou u by dou x and dou u by dou y. So first, dou u by dou x. See, log of root of x square plus y square, you can write 1 by 2 log of x square plus y square. You know logarithmic function formulas. So this root you can write in a front. Okay, 1 by 2 log of x square plus y square. Right. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate partially with respect to x. Dou u by dou x, you can say like u differentiate partially with respect to x. That is partial differential, partial derivatives, right? This 1 by 2. Log of x square plus y square differentiation with respect to x. So log of x, you know, 1 by x. So differentiate like 1 by x square plus y square. This x square differentiation 2x. 2 cancel, so x by x square plus y square. Next, u with respect to y. So this 1 by 2 constant, log of x square plus y square differentiation, 1 by x square plus y square. Again, differentiate this x square plus y square with respect to y. The x square 0, this x square differentiation 0, y square differentiation 2y, right in the numerator. 2 cancel, then y by x square plus y square. So, thank you for this valuable session, and we will see more integration, more different functions integration in the next class. Thank you. We leave now. Thank you.
Sir, thank you.
Sir, Karthikeyan, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.